The other method of joint space trajectory planning is using the method of linear interpolation. And in this method, the basic idea is to interpolate the initial position and the final position with a straight line. But this trajectory requires infinite acceleration at the beginning and infinite deceleration at the end. Why? Because to get this type of shape, we need this type of velocity. And the acceleration will be like this. And infinite acceleration, then suddenly zero and negative infinite acceleration. This much acceleration is not possible for any kind of actuator. So this limitation makes this approach very difficult if we don't add something at the beginning and at the end. So to tackle this problem, what we do, we add a parabolic blender at the beginning and at the end. So with the addition of these parabolic blends, we make the acceleration at the beginning and deceleration at the end to a limited or to a defined value. So for these two segments, we get constant acceleration if we use parabolic blends. The linear function from this point to this point and two parabolic functions, one here and one here, are splined together so that the entire path is continuous in position and in velocity. Okay, so this linear function with parabolic blend can be described by this equation. So if you take the first order derivative of this equation, you will get theta dot t is equal to c1 plus equal to t and theta double dot is equal to c2. So initially, at t is equal to 0, the velocity is 0, so c1 will be equal to 0. At t is equal to 0, the position is theta 0 or theta initial theta I, so c0, by putting t is equal to 0, we will get theta I is equal to c0. So after substituting all these constraints in this expression, we get theta t is equal to theta I plus half c2t square. It gives theta dot t is equal to c2t and theta double dot t is equal to c2. Then the question arises that how to find this time tb and the corresponding position of the profile. So for that, we follow this procedure. We have divided the trajectory into several segments. So at this point, the velocity is assumed 0 and the velocity in linear segment from here to here is assumed omega. And the velocity at the final position is assumed 0. So with these boundary conditions, we can find out the joint positions at point A and point B, and also the velocity at point A and point B. Okay, so using the previously derived expression, we can find out the expression of position at point A, and it will be theta A is equal to theta I plus half C2 TB square. Take derivative and we will get theta I dot is equal to c2 tb is equal to omega, because omega is constant from point A to point B. At point B, the position can be represented by theta b minus theta a by the time difference from here to here. So if we divide this theta b minus theta a by this time difference, then this will give us the angular velocity omega. This equation has been written like this: theta b is equal to theta a plus omega tf minus tb minus tb, and after simplification, we get is equal to theta a plus omega tf minus 2tb. If we take derivative, then we get theta b dot is equal to theta a dot is equal to omega. And because we know that acceleration in this period and in this period is constant, and the acceleration in these two periods are same, so we can say that theta f, the position at this point, minus theta b should be equal to theta a minus theta I. So this expression has been written in this form. Take derivative of this expression, you will get theta f dot is equal to 0. And just simplify this equation, and this equation gives C2 is equal to omega by TB, and simplify this equation using this equation and this equation, we get theta f is equal to theta I plus c2 t b square plus omega tf minus 2 tb. Put c2 is equal to omega by tb and we get theta f is equal to theta I plus omega by tb into tb square plus omega tf minus 2 tb. So this equation can be simplified for obtaining the time tb, and the expression of tb will be equal to theta I minus theta f plus omega into tf. Omega, this constant velocity, into total time tf divided by constant velocity omega. Now take two possible choice of linear path with parabolic blends, and in this we have taken a smaller blend, a blend with a smaller time period, and in this case the blend is taken for a longer period of time. So the constant velocity in this case is for larger period of time, and in this case it is for smaller period of time. So if we take its derivative of velocity, then acceleration profile will look like this, and you can see that acceleration is applied for a smaller period of time, but the magnitude is higher as compared to this profile. In this profile, a smaller acceleration has been applied for a longer period. So if the motor is capable of producing a smaller torque or a smaller acceleration, then we should use this type of trajectory. And if there are no limit of acceleration or torque produced by the joint, then we can use this type of trajectory. So as per the requirement, we define the trajectory of a robot. So you can use these YouTube links for understanding the trajectory planning from MATLAB point of view in MATLAB framework. So some MATLAB tutorials are given in these YouTube links. You can also analyze the trajectory planning concept in a robot, in different robots, on robo analyzer platform, and for that you need to follow the following steps. So first of all, select any kind of robot and define the DH parameters for that robot in this space. Then follow the following step. The first step is to define the initial and final values of joint variables. So you can define the theta initial and theta final. Then set the time duration and the number of steps in which you want to simulate your behavior. So that can be assigned in this place, in this space. Then set the gravity value and set the center of gravity of different links. And then select mass properties like mass of each link and inertia tensor. And then select the polynomial. It may be cycloid, this is cubic, cosine. So select any one out of these options, and just to play the simulation, and you will get all the graphs of trajectory planning. Thank you so much.